Welcome back to accountancy class. Up to now we have learnt about journal entries and again their ledger postings. Journal is known as book of primary entry, whereas ledger is known as book of secondary entry. Okay, so initially any transaction will be posted in journal, then it will be transferred to ledger book. Ledger book is a book of accounts, various accounts. Okay, see, if it is a small organization, means all transactions can be recorded in journal first initially, and again they can be easily posted in a ledger. But
yes sir,
in very big organization what happens, every day crores of rupees transaction will take place. Crores of rupees worth transactions will take place every day. So it will be very, very difficult to write for each transaction initially in a journal book and again posting them into ledger will be very, very difficult. It is cumbersome. Okay, it takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of effort. So what they will do is they will generally maintain subsidiary books. Subsidiary books. Yes, you okay. I will find out here. Okay, I will check it here. See here, you can see subsidiary books. Okay, so they will not record in journal directly. In subsidiary books, they will maintain. Okay, this is known as a special journal. It is also known as journal proper, means without entering transactions into journal book or without posting them into separate journal ledger, they will maintain subsidiary books. Means they need not post in journal, and again maintaining a separate account for each of the transaction is not required for big organizations. It is not advisable. So they will maintain these books separately. Those books are cash book, purchases returns book, sales book, and sales returns book. Did you understand? Directly they will maintain cash book. Directly they will maintain purchases book. Directly they will maintain purchases return book. Similarly, sales book, sales return book, and journal proper. These books they will maintain separately. Okay, they cannot enter in a journal, and again the posting in ledger is very, very difficult for them. Okay, see, we will start with purchases book. Actually, in your textbook you will find cash book first, but we will start with purchases book, purchases returns book, sales returns book. These are easy, you can easily understand. Then we will go to cash book.
Okay,
so now I will show you one example. Right. See, this is the pro forma of purchases book. Okay. See, purchases book, simply date, invoice number. See, what is invoice? Invoice is a document in which details regarding the quantity of the goods, the quality of the goods, any advance payment, what are the various conditions, what is the price. Okay, everything will be date of purchase, date of sales, everything will be mentioned in invoice. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
All the details regarding a transaction will be mentioned in invoice. So name of the supplier, means from whom the goods are purchased, will be there. LF number, ledger folio number, will be there. Means whatever, see, we are eliminating journal entries. You will balance, you will total it, and the total will be posted in a ledger book. Means purchases account you will maintain now in a ledger books. In that book,
yes,
directly you are going to post the balance, that's all.
Okay,
you are eliminating journal, that's all.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is what you are going to see. But remember, in purchases book, to while maintaining purchases book, you have to remember two things importantly. One is only credit purchases will be recorded in purchases book. Okay, cash purchases means in cash account you will maintain, that's all. Okay, second one, when you purchase only goods which are purchased for resale purpose only then you will use this purchases book. Otherwise you should not write in this purchases book. Suppose furniture purchased, your organization is not a furniture organization, it is not a furniture shop, then you should not write here. Just like in journal entries, furniture purchased means we are writing journal entry as furniture account at R2 cash account. Okay, if it is a transaction means furniture account at R2, that person's name or organization's name you are mentioning, but you are not writing purchases account at R2. Here also, only when the goods are purchased, those goods which you are going to resell, only those articles you are going to maintain in, you are going to mention in purchases. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I will show you one example. See, purchased from Messrs. Nima Electronics. Okay. See, date August 4th, you are going to write. Invoice number, they will mention invoice number. If nothing is mentioned, means you leave it. Okay, invoice number 3250, they have mentioned. So, Nima Electronics, they mentioned. Okay, so now you see 20 mini size TVs at 2000 per piece. 20 into 2000, it will be 40,000 plus 15 into 12,500. You are going to mention less 20% trade discount you are going to give on all those transactions. Net amount you are going to write here.
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, on August 10th, Pavan Electronics, you are going to mention the net amounts you are going to mention. Trade discounts you are going to allow. Net amounts you are going to mention. Did you understand? Just like this.
Yes, sir.
What we are going to do is journal entries you need not write. See, crores of rupees transactions daily, big organizations are going to be involved in. It is a waste of time maintaining the journal entries for each and every transaction. So for main activities like purchases, sales, purchases, returns, sales, returns. Similarly, in your book, they are not mentioned, but bills receivable, bills payable, cash, for all these things, you are going to maintain a separate book. Those books are known as subsidiary books. Okay. Apart from this, you are going to maintain a journal proper. What is journal proper? When after the completion of all these 5-6 important books is over, we will go to journal proper. Okay. All those transactions which cannot be recorded in these books, means sales book, purchases book, sales returns book, purchases returns book, cash book, bills receivable, bills payable, cash. All those books, whatever transactions that you cannot record in all those books, remaining transactions will be recorded in journal proper. That is what you mean by saying journal proper. When it comes, I will mention, I will show you. Okay?
Okay.
This example you understood, no? Simply, just diary,
yes, sir.
You will eliminate journal and you will mention whenever purchases take place, you will directly mention here. Okay, we will do one textbook problem. See, similarly, okay. This purchases returns book. See, if you do not like, you purchased from outsiders, you did not like it because of damage or because of color or because of any other quality. After purchasing, you verified it. You will return if conditions permit, you will return it. So then, see here, date. Here in the purchases book, you are going to mention as invoice number. But in purchases returns book, you have to mention it as debit note number. Why debit note? See, purchases is always for you debit. You know it in general.
Yes.
Mentioned purchases means debit. See, when you are returning a purchased item, what you are going to do? You are going to debit his account. When you purchase from outsiders on a credit basis, you will give him credit initially, but when you return that item, you are going to debit his account, that person's account. So in order to notify that, in order to record that, you are going to issue a debit note in outsider's name. Okay, so that is why in purchase returns book, debit note will come. In sales returns book, credit note number will come. Okay. Remaining is same. Name of the supplier, LF number, means ledger folio number, amount rupees, like this. Okay. So we will do one problem now. Right, other subsidiary books. This 13th problem in page number 156, it is there. We will do. Okay, 13th problem. Yes. Note down. 13th problem. Directly open the textbook 156 page. So we will start with the purchases book, purchases returns book, sales returns book. We will go to cash book. Okay.
Yes, sir.
What I will do is, are you able to see this Word document?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I have copied this all transactions. Yeah, I will increase the size. These are the four transactions, no? You check, you can check. Is it visible? Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you draw the pro forma. What is the pro forma? Showed, no? Solution. That one is the date, then invoice number, particulars, LF number, and amount rupees. Okay, first one is date, then particulars, then yes, sorry, particulars will come here. This is invoice number. Is it correct? Then LF number. Then amount rupees. Is it correct? You please check the pro forma. Date, invoice number, particulars, LF number, amount rupees.
Is written as name of the supplier.
Yes, please. Yes, I did not get you.
Sir, it is not there as particulars, sir. It is there as name of supplier.
Ah, okay, okay, right. In place of particulars, name of the supplier.
Yes.
Okay, right. Okay, right. You note down the pro forma first.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now first 01 date. Month is not given, no? Okay, month is given. Of July 2017 it is given. So 01, then 07, 2017. Okay. So what is the invoice number for the first transaction? That is 20041. You can see.
20041.
Okay. 20041. Name of the supplier. What is his name? Rahul Traders.
Rahul Traders.
Okay, I'll mention. LF number, you leave it. As per pro forma, you have to mention. Now you see, yes. What is the amount? See, in working notes, you have to do it. Working notes. Now you see, 40 ink pads at the rate of 8 each. And 40 into 8, it will give us 320 rupees. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then second one. What is the second one? Mm-hmm. 50 files at the rate of 10 each. 50 into 10, it will give us 500. Okay. Then third one.
Sir, in textbook it is there as 18 gel pens.
Okay, okay. Sorry. I missed it. Okay, I have correctly mentioned this one. On 15th transaction, I am mentioning. Okay, no problem. I will take it for 15th date. First one, I will do like this. Okay? First date, I missed this date. Okay. Now, you see, 40 register set, 60 each. 40 into 60. Okay? 40 into 60. It will give us 2,400. Is it correct? Yes, 40 into 60, no? First one is 50.
Yes, sir.
Register set the rate of 60 each. Then second one, 80 gel pen set the rate of 15 each. So 80
yes.
into 15. Yes, what is the value? 80 into 15 means? 1200 it will be. You check it once. 15 8 is 120, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next. Then 15... each. Then 50 notebooks at 20 each. So 50 into 20. What is the value? 1000, no? So it will be 1000. You check it. What is the total? $4,600. See,
yes.
See on this one, any trade discount is there? Trade discount 10%.
10%.
So on 4,600 at the rate of 10% means, see, directly what you do is direct amount we have to write means 10% you less from 100 means 90, no? Into 90% you calculate
yes,
directly. 90%.
Okay.
Will give us how much? 4,600 into 90%. 4,600 into 90%. It is 4140. It will be equal to 4140. You calculate it. Okay. 4,600.
Okay.
I will do it. See, you should not use calculator. No. 4,600 into 90 by 100. Okay, year 10 I am cancelling, year 0, 0, 0. 9 zeros are 0, 9 6 are 54, 4, 5. Okay, 9 4 is 36, 36 plus 5 41. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So it is 41 40. So in outer column you mention it as 41 40. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now coming to second date transaction, what is the second date? It is on 15th. Okay, 15th.
Yes, sir. 15th.
2017. What is the invoice number? 1132.
1132.
Okay. Then who is the supplier? Global Stationers.
Yes, sir.
LF number you leave it. Now for this you have to do working notes. This is second working notes. Now you see, first one is 40 into 80 320, 50 into 10 500. I mentioned these two. Then third one, 10 into 20. Okay, 10 into 20, it is equal to 200. Okay? Next.
Yes.
Oh, not 20 color books into 20, no? 20 color books at the rate of 20.
Yes.
So it is 20 into 20 means it will be 400. Okay? Only these three are there in the second one, you see. 40 into 8, 50 into 10, 20 into 20.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what is the total? 1220 came for me. You cross check. Is it correct? Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 1220 into what is the trade discount here? 5%. Okay, 5% means what we shall write? 95/100. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So I am calculating it. 1220 into 95/100. 0, 0 I am cancelling. Okay. 5 2s are 5 19s. 5 2s are 5 19s. Okay. 5 20s are 100. No, just 1 5 less.
Yes, sir.
That is why I have taken 19. Okay. Here 2 ones are 261. Okay. So 61 into 19. You calculate 61 into 19. 19 ones are 19. 9 1. 19 6 are 54.
I'm sorry.
114 it seems. Okay, otherwise we will do just simply 9 ones are 9, 9 6 are 54. Okay.
Yes.
Then 1 ones are 1, 1 6 are 6. Now we add this 9 5 11. Okay. 11 15.
Yes, sir.
So 1159 you take. 1159. Next one, after 15th date, what is the next date? 23rd July 2017. What is the invoice number? 3201. 3201. Lamba Furniture. Supplier's name is Lamba Furniture. Okay. LF number is nothing is there. So two chairs at 600. What is the total? Two chairs at 600. Third one. 2 × 600.
1200.
Then second one. What is the second one?
One table at 3000.
One table at the rate of 1000. 1 × 1000. Which is equal to 1,000. So total is 2,200, no?
Yes, sir.
No, there is no trade discount here, you can see.
No, sir, no trade discount.
So 2,200. Okay, next one. That is after 23rd date, it is? Sorry. 25/7/2017. What is the invoice number? 444. 4-1. Okay. 10 paper rims at 100 per rim.
1000.
Okay. Fourth one. 10 × 100. It will give us 1000. Okay. Second one is much. 400 drawing sheets at 3 each.
400.
Okay. 400 × 3 will give us 1200. The next one. What is the next one? 20 packets of water color at 40 per packet. 20 × 40.
800.
There is no trade discount, no? So it is 3000. You can check. 2200 plus 800. 3000. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So you have to mention. I did not mention the supplier's name. What is it? Mumbai Traders. $3,000. Okay. Is it 3000? Okay, right. Fine. Now
yes,
you total it. What is the total? It is 9. Again 9.
10,499.
So this is, you have to mention it here. Yes, did you understand?
Yes, sir, understood.
Note down. Have you noted?
Yes, sir, noted.
Noted? Okay. 10,490. Shall we move to the next problem then?
Yes, sir.
Yes. What is this total of purchase book? Like this came. 8,299. Okay, ignore. Did we make any mistake? No mistake is there, no?
No, sir.
Okay, no problem. Okay? If no mistake is there, means no problem. See properly. Anything we missed otherwise, you see from the textbook. Okay, no mistake is there. In the third transaction and fourth transaction, no trade discounts are there, no? We did not miss anything.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that is correct only. Ours is correct only. Okay. anything we missed, you see here or anywhere? Cross check. No mistake. Okay, no mistake is there. We are correct only. Okay, don't worry. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next problem. In sales book, see, enter the following transactions in sales book of Messrs. You have to pronounce as Messrs. Okay. Bansal Electronics. So sold to this. All transactions are given, including bill number. Bill number means invoice number only. Please remember. Okay.
Okay.
Will you do this 14th one?
Yes, sir. I will do.
You do and tell me the answer. Now you do. Okay. Okay. See, I cross-checked. See what happened. This is a stationery shop actually. You see, all registers are purchased in the first transaction, first date. You see, registers, gel pens, notebooks. Okay. Second one, from stationers, colors, books, ink pads, files.
Yes,
they have purchased. Now you see, in the fourth transaction, you see 25th date. Drawing sheets, paper rim, water colors. See, this is a stationery shop totally. Okay, but now you see,
yes,
on the 23rd date, you see, furniture they purchased. This furniture they purchased not for sales. Please remember, for the office use they purchased, for the shop's purpose. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
I mentioned right the introduction. When purchase are made only to resell those goods, only then you are going to write. Okay, this will come in journal proper. I mentioned, no, purchases book, purchases returns, sales returns book, or cash book, bills receivable, bills payable, all those books, whatever transactions will come, they you are going to mention. Remaining transactions you have to mention in journal proper, not here. Okay, so on 23rd, this you have to eliminate actually. We have included by mistake.
Yes.
We did not check it. Okay, this 23rd date you eliminate. You can get it. Okay, did you understand the logic?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay, now you check it. The answer will be here. 2 is going to be there. Here,
8,299.
Like this. You understood, no?
Yes, sir, understood.
I missed it actually. But when I cross-checked with the textbook, I came to know that it is furniture being purchased. That is not for resale. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Heading you have to mention compulsory. That is purchases book. This you have to mention compulsory purchases. Purchases book of what is the person's name? Of this entirely you have to write.
Gupta Traders.
Messrs. Gupta Traders. We have to pronounce as
Messrs.
So this you have to write in entirety. Okay, did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please correct it. That mistake you corrected, that rectification you do it.
Okay, sir.
Now you solve the next problem. Okay. 14th one, you do it. Shivani, once you are going to write in sales book, no? Next problem. That is sales book, no? Next problem.
Yes, sir. Sales it is.
Okay, now you see. Sales book, you will mention the person's name, the company name, the shop name you are going to mention. See, date will remain the same. Invoice number will remain the same. But you see, he is not supplier, no? You should mention that as customer. Name of the customer.
Okay, sir.
Okay, he is not supplier. Okay, he is customer to us. So that change you make in the heading and you do the problem.
Sir?
Yes, now I unmuted. Now you tell me.
Sir, on the first date, third transaction amount is not given, sir.
What is that? You tell me once. Will you read?
It is there as 10 sold to Arun Electronics as per bill number.
As per bill number?
4351.
4351. Next, continue.
That's it, sir.
Only that much is given?
Yes, sir.
No, it is there. No, you check it. I will show you. Now you see, it is here, no? Sold to Amit Traders. Bill number is given. 20 packet radios. It's 70 per radio. It is given, no? You check it properly.
No, sir. After that.
What?
Third line.
After third line. Third one. Okay. This one?
Yes, sir.
10 sold to Arun Traders. Okay. You leave that one. You leave that one. Tenth one, you leave it. You leave that one. No problem. Okay. Fourth, five TV sets. This you do. This.
Okay.
This 10th one you are leaving, no?
Yes, sir.
See, but you see, this 10th is date actually. You bring it to here. There is a print mistake.
Okay.
10th sold to Arun Electronics as per bill number.
Okay, okay, sir.
In 10th date, you write these two transactions. Okay? Now it will
okay.
come. Okay, 43,100, no? Same, no? You check it.
Yes, sir.
First transaction, it will be 24,000, 7,500, 8,000. Total, it will give you 43,100.
Yes, sir.
Okay? So this is the book, no? You understood, no, these two purchases book, how to prepare?
Yes, sir, I understood.
13th problem and 14th problem. Okay? 15th and 16th are returns. This is return inward, means they are sales returns. This is purchases return. One is purchases return and another one is sales return. So this 15 and 16, tomorrow we will do. In the next class, we will do. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Thank you very much, then.
Thank you, sir.